Tim Ginever, please. Congratulations, Timmy.
Thanks, Sada. Wrote me speech on the name card. Can't believe it's fair dinkum. I thought you were taking a piece. I really did, Jake, when you rang me. I thought, this can't be serious. I mean, I grew up idolising, obviously, Port Adelaide champions, and I thought, you know, one day I might have the handball of Russell Ebert or the kicking skills of a Brian Cunningham or the speed of a John Cale. I ended up with the height, the leg speed, and the weight of a wombat. Didn't really get a lot, did I? But anyway, I have a lot of people to thank for getting here. It's, as the other guy said, and congratulations to everybody else that's been inducted into the SA Hall of Fame. It's a great honour. And I think there's a lot of people you do have to thank. First and foremost, Travel Superstore obviously has to be thanked. Is that right?
You might get a flight out of this, Timmy.
Well, absolutely. Travel Super, good on you, Hodgie. But I was the only bloke that provided his own highlights too, so I thought it was terrific of me. I mean, to get anywhere, I think, in a team game, there's a lot of people that have to have an influence on your life. And for me, first of all, it's my family. I want to thank Mum and Dad, Michael, John, Christopher, Nicholas, Philip, Wendy, Linda, Alison and Anne. I think that's it. I'm one of 10 kids. I've got seventh child syndrome. Whatever that is. I grew up in a beautiful leafy suburb of Adelaide, Mansfield Park. It was leafy. Come in a little bag about so big, cost $30. You can still get it, Leon. You can still get it. Yeah, it was an interesting place, but I was the youngest of six boys, and when I was playing football, my brothers wanted me to play for Port Adelaide, and I certainly did. They kept me in line as far as, you know, your confidence levels goes, because I was playing good footy and I was winning some awards, and Mum would put our trophies on the mantelpiece at home, and we'd a beautiful housing trust home, and that she would put the trophies up there, and my brother Nick had the largest one that sat in the middle. And I went to the best and fairest in 1980, and there had been a thing called plastic invented, and they made these new trophies, and they were massive, and they were sort of gold-plated plastic crap, but they looked magnificent. And I remember going to the evening thinking, oh, shit, if I win that, that's going to be bigger than Nick's, and there's going to be trouble. So I've won it, I've got home, and I thought, I'll go to the back door, they won't see me. And I've walked in the back door, and I've hit it behind my back. And as I walked in, I could see Nick and Phil sitting there, and they said, hey, what are you doing? I said, nothing, nothing. And they said, you had the best and fairest tonight, didn't you? I said, yeah, yeah, yeah. They said, how'd you go? I said, I was lucky enough I won. And they said, you get a trophy? I said, yeah, I got one. Give me a look at it. And I started running because I knew this was trouble. They ran, they pinned me down, they picked it up. Nick grabbed it out of my hands, ran over to the mantelpiece, put it on the mantelpiece. Of course, it was that much higher than his. He said, you bigoted little bastard. Chased me down, gave me the old typewriter. Bing! Bing! And then the old spittle. Down there it goes, and up it comes. You've all had it done to you. You've all had it done to you. But that kept me on the level. That kept me humble. Until I went to Port Adelaide, and then I got carried away. But my first arrival there, and I must admit it was a big moment to get one of my first games at Albert and Oval. And Russell was my first coach. He's still playing. And I can remember, this is a fair dinkum story. I'm at Albert and Oval. Tim Evans, Russell Ebert, and me. And I'm standing there, and I remember just got caught staring. And I was just looking. And I was like that until Tim Evans said, hey, get out of my fucking space. So I had to run out. The rest of Russell said, you concentrating on what? And I'm looking at him, I'm going, oh, do I ask for an autograph now or later? I'm not sure. It was a big moment. So got through that. And then you obviously play a few games. And then we got to play in premierships. And John Carlu, I'm sitting next to tonight. I did say to Jack just the other day when we caught up last year, I just said to him, look, besides my family, you're the second biggest influence on my life. Gave me the confidence and belief in myself to believe that I could play decent footy. And then of course, we had terrific success. And I think in moments like this, you have to make sure that you thank your family. And more importantly, you know, I heard Brett James thank his wife and the other guys, Rocket, and that. I've had some tough opponents. I've had Gary McIntosh, you know, step on my head and use it as a welcome mat. But I don't think I've met a tougher opponent than my wife, Ange. So she is fierce at it, let me tell you. So thank her. But also, I think when it comes to a team game, you've got to thank your teammates. And all of us who have won individual awards all acknowledge that you can't be anything unless you've got your teammates. So I was very fortunate. First sign I saw when I walked into Alberton was individuals win the ball, teams win games, but clubs win premierships, and I'm very, very thankful that I played at my football club. Thank you.
Congratulations, Timmy Ginever. Timmy, just I'll grab you for a second before we've got to go get ready. Timmy, I think five inductees, four other awardees. You are the ninth person up on the stage, but you're the first man to be wearing makeup. What is going on?
A leftover from the weekend.
You, of course, got it ready. You'll be involved a little bit later on.
Yep.
Good to see you cleaned out the magic words before the cameras start rolling way, Timmy. You said you're the seventh child out of 10.
Yeah.
And seven premierships to go with that. Timmy, when you win so many like you and your Port Adelaide teammates, which is phenomenal, there are guys with six, seven, eight, even Jeff Motley with nine, like the Gowans twins. Do you remember every single one of them, or do they start to blur into it? Are they like children?
Well, I've got three children and they're here tonight, and one looks like she's from Sweden, one looks like she's from Italy, and the other one's a Frenchman, so I've got no idea.
How did your wife go when she went backpacking?
terrifically well, obviously. One's tall as well. I don't know what's going on. Questions have to be asked.
Seven flags, though. Do you remember each one individually? Because it's a stand, like, if anyone in the room plays in one premiership, it's like a life achievement. But to play in seven of them, do you guys at Port Adelaide understand how lucky you are?
Oh, look, they're very, very special. And I remember every single sort of moment in footy games regardless. The thing about, I suppose, the great blokes that I played with and why I'm so proud of is that when we get together, all we do is take the piss out of each other and find the worst games that we played and just pick on that. We don't ever talk about those glory days because that can get a bit boring and, you know, a bit me. I think the great thing is that the humbleness and certainly, you know, my brothers taught me that very early, that comes into it, and I think it's very important. You know, you won't hear Russell Ebert talk about himself when his statue was unveiled. He just talked about the pigeon sitting on his nose. I mean, I love that sort of stuff. That's the humbleness that I think Aussies love.
Well, Timmy, I think 314 games, when the boys were picking on you, it would have been very hard to find a bad one amongst that. Congratulations. And I reckon that little plaque you've got there is going to look very nice against those trophies up at home when you drop it off to mum's
at the mantelpiece.
Absolutely. Timmy, Jennifer, thanks, congratulations. Mate. And we will see Timmy a little later in the evening once we get involved in the Magarey Medal count.